Okay, I'm not late, but I need to be quick because I need to revise for my mock I have today. I've already got flashcards here that I'm like looking at, so that I can like think. I'm just so fed up of getting off of school. I just can't do it anymore. Okay, if I get ready in the next like 8 minutes, then I should have like just under an hour to revise. This is so bad. I absolutely hate rushing, believe it or not, but like I just can't do it. Oh, this is so bad. I can't find my brush. Like, I literally have any of the brushes I need except my contour brush. Like, hello. And I'm gonna need to tan my face today because it's just not tanning. Like, I need to put on more bronzer and more contour just for it to look the same color as my bloody hands. Because the tan on my hands is always shocking. It always disappoints me because I don't even know why. Like, why? Like, it always goes hella patchy. I don't have time right now. Okay, he's put on a lot of bronzer because my face is set to pale, and I just don't have time. Okay, I don't have time to think right now. Okay, that is a ton better than how I looked before. I'm just gonna quickly spray my face and then do some blush. And my makeup is all over my table right now, so like I'm just pulling it from I don't even know the black hole. Okay, my setting spray is kind of dry. I'm just gonna put it over the top. I don't really care. I say it literally nearly every single day, but I can't get over how good this blush smells. Like. Okay, I'm just gonna do an extra setting spray. Just for good luck. I wanna do my mascara so speedy quick, like you've never seen before. Tell me why my makeup, when I'm in a rush, actually always looks so good. Okay, now my eyebrows look really weird. Okay, but I don't actually care. I was talking about, like, I don't really care how my eyebrows look, not if I dented this, which I didn't. But, my phone interrupted me. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, the final bit of scent spray, and I'm done. Gotta go revise now. Okay, I have just under an hour. Yay.
Hey guys, it's 4 a.m. Get ready with me for the airport. I've just discovered that our portable charger didn't charge. So we're going to Queensland for something special, which you guys will find out tomorrow. And then we fly home. Both fake tanned and mine is so dark. So, yeah, I forgot my elbow. So we're going to have to fix that up there. My hair straightened by a hairdresser and I am obsessed. I restocked on this moisturizer yesterday and I'm going to wear it because it seems a little bit more plain worthy than Glow Recipe. I don't know, that doesn't make any sense. What I think I'm going to do to fix this, I'm going to put a bit of tan on it now. I don't know, but it's so bad. My skin feels so good right now. I'm so happy. I don't know what to do from now because everything is packed. Pretty much. I'm not gonna put any makeup on for the plane. Just some lip gloss. Should I brush my eyebrows up? I don't know. I forgot my eyelash cream. Can't forget that. We're going for like, I swear, less than like 2 days. And we have packed so much. Literally just took me 5 minutes. These are our fits. We're like, mix matching. I forgot to do my lash lift thingamajiggy. Was I just filming? I can't tell if I was just filming. Well, if I wasn't, this is the, I don't know how to say that brand. But it's an advanced aftercare for your lash lift.
Alex was nice enough to lend me his headphones for the plane because he's got like noise.
Let's try
that, I did yesterday. He's got these noise cancelling headphones and they're really good. So I'm using them.
Okay, bye guys. Have an amazing day.
I am
honestly in such a good mood today and I literally love it. I've been on the treadmill for an hour doing a nice little walk. The sun has been out. I'm just feeling great today. So I just thought we could get ready for the day together because you're my besties and I love getting ready with you. And that's the brows done. Obviously joking. That was the benefit precisely my brow wax. Now I'm just wiping around the edges to obviously clean them up because I don't think I really want to walk around with brows like that. Obviously they still look absolutely crazy right now, but just trust the process. They'll look better when the rest of the makeup's done. Time for skincare. I'm using this Garnier Hyaluronic Aloe Plumping Serum. Tried this for the first time yesterday and I really like it, so thought I'd use it today under my makeup. And then another product that I've tried recently is this Kiehl's Calendula Serum Infused Water Cream. You know I literally love a water cream under my makeup, so this is so nice. And I'm gonna start sorting my hair out while I let all that skincare sink in before I do some SPF. Okay, I'm halfway through curling my hair. Thought I'd curl it today, push the boat out, you know. And I'm gonna put some SPF on now because I've let skincare sink in a little bit. And then I'm gonna let the SPF sink in for a bit while I'm doing the rest of my hair before I do my makeup. This is the L'Oreal Bright Reveal Dark Spot UV Fluid SPF 50, by the way. Can't forget about the neck. Okay, back to curling. See you soon. Okay, hair is curled. Obviously, I haven't brushed them out yet. I'm just leaving them like this so they don't drop too quickly. Not even particularly going anywhere. I'm going to get a patch test done because I'm getting my lashes lifted in a couple of days' time. And then I'm going to my nan and granddad's later to see them. But you know, sometimes just getting ready just sets you up for the day. And I just feel like it. So pushing the boat out by curling my hair as well. Put some of the Beauty Crop Avocado Primer on as per usual. Oh my god, I've been watching so much Friends again recently. I've obviously watched all seasons back to front so many times, but I haven't watched it in ages. But I've recently started it again, and honestly, it's just like my favourite. I literally love it. It's one of my comfort shows, definitely. That and Motherland are my comfort shows. Like, I could literally watch them at any point. I love them both so much. Let me know what your comfort shows are. I love hearing about comfort shows. But yeah, Friends and Motherland are definitely mine. I've just put some of the e.l.f. Halo Glow on as my bronzer. This is the shade 4. And then for cream blush, I'm going to put a Shy Boy Blush Balm from Made by Mitchell on. Just got that on a brush, and I'm going to pat that into my skin. And then I'm going to use my trusty Lancome concealer. This is just my absolute fave at the moment. I literally cannot put it down. I mean, it's been a fave for a while, but just at the moment, it's especially like, I just can't stop using it. The coverage it gives while still looking nice on the skin is just like, I just can't beat it at the moment. Oh my god, I dropped my Rare Beauty highlighter and it's all over the floor. That's the second Rare Beauty highlighter I've broken. Powder today, I'm going to use my Milk Makeup one. I never used to set my whole face with powder, but I've kind of started doing it because I just feel like it makes the rest of the makeup go on a lot nicer and smoother. So I apply it to my under eyes, obviously, with a powder puff. This is a Trigwell one. Then for the rest of my face, I just take it on a little fluffy brush. Just dust it everywhere else. You don't want a dense brush, you want like a nice fluffy one so it doesn't like pack too much powder onto the face. Bit of powder bronzer, I'm using this e.l.f. one. This is the primer infused bronzer, I think. Yeah. Primer infused bronzer. Time for blush. I have a new Armani shade to try. This is the shade 40, and look how stunning that looks. If you watch most of my videos, you'll know that shade 51 is one of my fave blushes ever. Look at that. Oh, stunning. I'm gonna take it on this little brush. This is the Peaches and Cream PC03, and I'm just gonna dust that on my cheeks. So pretty, so pigmented. Oh my god, wow. Gonna put some mascara on next. I'm using the YSL Lash Clash today. This makes your lashes look so fluffy. Glow Milk Mist to set. And as I said, I'm not really doing much today, so I'm not really gonna do my lips. I'm just gonna put some of the Elizabeth Arden cream on again. And that is me ready for the day. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a lovely day, and I'll see you soon. Bye.
Let's talk about the cons of doing social media in college. Firstly, there are thousands of pros. I don't want to come off as ungrateful because I am so incredibly grateful. I'm living my childhood dream right now, and I wouldn't trade that for the world, but every rose does have its thorns, and I thought this would be fun to share. My videos do get sent around in group chats where people brutally make fun of me. They think I'm a cringy, weird, friendless loser. Contrary to popular belief, I actually do have friends. I just don't post every single thing online, and I've learned a lot about respecting other people's privacy, so yeah. About a year ago, some people started a rumor about me that was completely false. Unfortunately, things got really out of hand, and it spread really, really far through my school, and a lot of people believed it. The worst part about the whole situation was it was when I was first getting diagnosed with my health issues, and I was too sick to be at school, so I was unable to defend myself or correct this rumor, so it just spread. I assumed things would just blow over during the summer and everyone would forget about it by the time we started school in August. But that didn't happen. People started telling the freshmen this rumor, and I honestly don't even know who knows it or who believes it at this point. I'm not gonna sit here and lie and say the situation didn't affect me. It did hurt my feelings and make me a little bit sad, but I posted every day through it and I continued to post every day, and I'm getting to do things that I only dreamed of, so oh well. I have had a few situations where people have tried to use me, but really not that bad. I know some people experience that really bad. I can easily tell when people are using me, but I'm bad about just letting them because I want other people to be happy, and if using me makes them happy, I kind of just let it happen. There's definitely people that just assume things about me based on my social media, and they don't really want to get to know me to see if those assumptions are true or not. They just kind of want to believe these negative assumptions. When I meet someone for the first time and we exchange contact information, and then they find out that I do social media, I feel like that's a really make it or break it moment for like a friendship, because some people just see that I do social media and then they don't want to be friends with me, which is fine. I probably get the most self-conscious when it comes to like boys finding out about my social media, because I would rather them get to know me first than just make assumptions. I'm gonna make another video talking about all the pros, because I wake up every single morning so excited and grateful that I get to do this as a job. I never would have imagined I'd be able to do something like this, and like I said, it was a childhood dream of mine, so I just feel so lucky that I'm able to do social media.
Good morning! Get ready with me to go out in London. Today is officially 2-up, which is second day of Chinese New Year, but we're not really like celebrating here. I mean, we're doing hot pot tonight, which is kind of late because usually people do hot pot for reunion dinner, but that's fine. Anyway, Jolin is in London and we're meeting. We actually met last night and we went clubbing. That's why my face is so puffy. Don't even get me started. Like, look at my eye. This eye is so swollen. Anyway, we're hanging out. She went back to her place to go freshen up. And then we're gonna meet for lunch and eat ramen because we already miss our Asian food. Like, I've been here for like a week. She's been here for 2 weeks. And I don't know, I just miss my Asian food. But it's so expensive here. My school officially starts on Monday. Today's Saturday. So I have 2 more days before my school starts. And if you're wondering, I'm in UAL, which is University of Arts London. University of the Arts London. So that's really fun. Like, we went for like a campus tour and everything. It was all good, so I'm excited to start school. I haven't really been vlogging much because there's 6 of us in this house, so it's kind of chaotic and I don't really want to like shove a camera into everyone's faces. And also, I share a room with my roomie. Basically, if you don't know, we were like homeless because our Airbnb was a fraud, so we booked this temporary home as we were finding like our permanent home. But we already found a permanent home, so we're moving out of this place soon. But anyway, for now, I'm sharing a room with my roommate. I'm sharing a bed with my roommate. And even if we move into the new house, we're still sharing a bed. God, my face is really so swollen. I'm gonna be wearing these glasses. I haven't done my hair, so please excuse me. I'm gonna be wearing these glasses so that like I can block like the puffiness, and my eye, this eye is so swollen, so hopefully it'll cover. You know, I feel like I've been eating better here than back in Singapore, because here, like, all my roommates and I will rotate like the cooking and stuff, so we cook every single meal, not every single meal, like we eat out, oh my god, we eat out like once a day, which is why I've been spending so much money, because the food here in London is so expensive. But anyway, we've been cooking every day, and like the food that my roommates cook, it's so good. Like, they're all professional chefs. Like, yesterday we had kimchi fried rice, but their fried rice, it was so good because they added like beef and like... Okay, I kind of have to rush because I'm supposed to leave in like 2 minutes, but I just started my makeup, so... And oh my god, I cannot be so loud because I have so many other roommates still sleeping. Okay, this is the final look. I think it's pretty cute. My hair, my bangs, I'm not gonna do much about it. Okay, let me see with the glasses. Also, I'm going to be vlogging today, so stay tuned for YouTube content because I'm trying to expand into long-form video. So yeah, see you, bye!
I have fallen in love with my morning skincare routine because it makes me look like a little glazed donut. I've tried so many different combinations of products and I've finally got a routine that I know like works so well. It's great under makeup and my skin
just be beaming. First thing that I like to use is these. These are the MediHeal Vitamide Brightening Pads. Now, I saw these all over TikTok. They are Korean skincare, so I bought them off the site, and I'm not gonna lie, they did take ages to come. I don't personally think that you need two, but I always see the lady who inspired me to get these use two, so I'm using two. They really help with brightening the skin, so I massage the pads all over my face. I try and use them every morning. Now, next up is my Ren AHA Daily Tonic. Now, I was a diehard fan of this about 2 years ago, and then I just stopped using it because I went on to using my Paula's Choice again, like every day. But for the past month or so, I don't know what's going on with my skin. I've been getting really dry, flaky skin around my nose, on my chin. So I started reaching for this again because AHAs eat away your dead skin cells, where BHAs unclog and clean your skin from the inside out. So this helps declog your pores, whereas this helps like eat away dead skin cells and resurface the top layer of your skin. It's also great for brightening because that's what it is. Like, AHAs eat away your dead skin cells, help resurface that top layer of the skin and make your skin look really bright. 2 steps in and my skin is already beaming. Next up, I'm gonna put on my Glow Hub Hyaluronic Acid. I use this every morning, every evening. I just kind of slip it into the serum section of my skincare routine. I use one full pump and I just press and massage this onto my skin. I try and do it when my skin's still a little bit damp, just to help suck it in through even more hydration. I mean, I've spoke about this for years at this point. It's also got polyglutamic acid in, so it's my favorite hyaluronic acid over all high-end hyaluronic acids, because it just makes my skin look extra juicy, extra plump. Now, if I have scarring on my skin, which I do right now because I've been picking some spots, best believe that scarring is only staying with me for 1 to 2 weeks max. Like, they ain't overstaying their welcome. I use every brightening serum under the sun to make sure these bad boys go as quick as possible. And one of them is my Scar Slayer. Whoa, now this, hands down, could not live without this for helping getting rid of your scarring. I don't apply it to my entire face because I've got other products that work for my entire face with brightening, but this on the targeted areas where I'm suffering with scarring right now that I want it to disappear, vanish, that is your girl. Like, you will find nothing that shifts your scarring as quickly as this will. Quickly just gonna pop on a little bit of eye cream. I bounce around a few different eye creams. I love the Caudalie one, I love this Ulla Henriksen one. I recently bought a Kiehl's one from a recommendation off Tati, so I need to start using that, but right now she's very loved. Last serum, I promise, but this is the be all and end all, the mother of all serums. It's my Caudalie Vino Perfect serum. Whoa, my hands are so slippy. I wish over my time I had kept how many bottles of this that I had gone through, because I am not even joking, I would probably have 25 plus. What the Vino Perfect serum does is it just helps brighten the skin, make the skin not look dull, make it so glowy, and it is a dark spot treatment, so again, it's another layer of helping with scarring, dark spots, a little bit of pigmentation. It's just an all-round great product for radiance, brightening and glowiness. Moisturizer of choice, this is my Tatcha Dewy Skin Cream. I am just obsessed still with this at the moment. I've been through like 3 tubs now in the past, I don't know, not that very long. You really want that glass skin dew hydration on your face. She's expensive, but she is so worth it. Like, it gives you the glowiest skin. Then SPFs. I have a few fave SPFs. So this is a more affordable one. It's the Defend Yourself by Glow Hub. She is only an SPF 30 though. Or for SPF 50s, I love the Charlotte Tilbury Primer because it's a primer as well. So it also blurs your skin whilst giving you an SPF 50. And then also my Paula's Choice. Oh, Essential Glow, love her so much. It makes your skin look like you have a glowy filter on, but it is only an SPF 30. I really wish they'd come out with a 50 of this. Today we'll use the Charlotte Tilbury one. This also makes you look like you have like a little glowy filter on, because again, it's got like a little bit of an iridescent cast to it, which like filterizes your face. It's gorgeous. And that is my glowy morning skincare routine. I go and do my food shopping looking like a glazed donut.
I cut my eyes
looks really small on this morning.
Grabbing a sweatshirt though because it's so cold.
It's 5:36. Woke up at 5 and then went outside and I let my dogs out and I fed them and they ended up all waking up. There's two of them. I really don't want to put on a lot of makeup, like literally maybe 2 or 3 products, because when I wash my face later, I really don't want to irritate this. I think I'm gonna wear black leggings and a long sleeve pink top with my vest. Yeah, at least the cut like isn't right on my lash line, but it's definitely close, so I'm being super careful. So honestly, this looks kind of weird because I couldn't fully even curl this eye because of the cut. But this is probably gonna go down in a little bit, so it should be even soon. I also couldn't get an appointment in time for Valentine's Day nails.
Okay, so this is what I'm wearing. Definitely gonna end up switching around these rings, but for now, this is just what I'm gonna wear. Everything I use is also linked to my Amazon storefront. These are so good. Per usual, I'm bringing my chair over, so while my waffles are in the toaster, I'm gonna sit here by the heater. Okay, I put on my vest. I'm really debating wearing my pop pink Converse, but it doesn't really match, but like, that's okay, right? I'm so late for my vest right now. Because it's literally gonna be here in like a minute. I'm running. Oh my god, look at how pretty it is. My AirPods, I'm quick.
Hey guys, get ready with me for school. I'm running a bit late today because my alarm didn't go off this morning. Like, I must not have set it, but I thought I'd set it. I set it for 6 and then I woke up at like 7:10. Also, happy Valentine's. I cannot wait because my friends and I keep talking about this. I'm just so excited. I went shopping yesterday and I bought decorations for it. The only thing we haven't decided on is what rom-com to watch. So if you guys have any good suggestions, please let me know. This is like an SPF face spray. Haven't used it in ages, but I love it. Well, this one's like the body one, but the mini one's like a face one. But I'm pretty sure I read it and it was like the same ingredients. So I think it's pretty good. Also, I made a matcha. It's so good. I've been putting like white chocolate syrup in. Usually I prefer vanilla syrup. Okay, I need to stop talking. I need to go because I'm late. I also bought some new products yesterday. This is the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, but I just got the mini. Actually, I'm just going to put this Glossier skin tint over the top. And then I finally did it. I finally bought the full size airbrush flawless filter because I keep buying the mini and I'm like running out. So I finally did it and bought the full size. And it's such a good setting spray. Pretty sure MCO Beauty duped it. So I'd like to try the dupe like one day as well if I run out of this one. I have double maths today, which is not the best, but we're having like a class party, which is going to be really exciting because so many people have their birthdays. So I'm on the level 3 beauty loop and I got this full size NARS lip gloss, which is so cool and it's really pretty. So this is great. It has like a tiny little tint, but you can't even tell, which is so good, especially for like school. Okay, I just put my hair in a ponytail because it is stinking hot today. And bye guys, I hope you have a lovely Valentine's Day.